In this video, we're going to practice using Euler's method. Here are the directions. Consider the initial value problem, y prime of t equals 2t plus y, with y of 0 equals 2. Use Euler's method, with delta t equals 0.5, to calculate the first three approximations, u1, u2, and u3. So I'm not going to go into any great detail about Euler's method, the theory behind it, because you should have already learned that. But I will just remind you of the basic idea. So we have this differential equation here, y prime of t. And there's some solution to this y of t, but perhaps the solution is very difficult to find or maybe impossible to find. So instead, what we're going to do is we're just going to try to approximate that solution at different points in time. And Euler's method is a way of getting those approximations. So here I'm told that we're going to use delta t equals 0.5, and that's simply the length of each of our time steps, or the distance between the time steps. So if I just wanted to write out those time steps, we're starting at time equals 0, so I say t sub 0 equals 0, and from then on we just go up in steps of 0.5. So then t1 would be 0.5, t2 would be 1, and t3 would be 1.5, and then so on. And my goal here is to calculate the first three approximations, u1, u2, and u3. So since I'm using these time steps, delta t equals 0.5, u1 is going to be an approximation to y of 0.5. And then u2 will be an approximation to y of 1. And u3 will be an approximation to y of 1.5. So that's what we're trying to do here. So probably our first step should be just to write down the formula for Euler's method. And that formula looks like this. U of k plus 1 equals uk plus f of tk comma uk times delta t. So let's think about what these different pieces represent. So uk plus 1, this is just going to give me the next approximation, right? The next iteration in this process. And then uk just represents the value that I already have, right? So maybe I'm trying to find u2, and so I use the value u1 to do that. And so then we see this f of something, of tk uk. So this f refers to the function that I see in my differential equation. So in my case then, f of ty is 2t plus y. Okay, so I'll be using that to calculate these Euler method approximations. And then delta t is, of course, our time step, which we're given, 0.5. One other thing we need to start this process is a starting point, which we call u0. Now this is actually going to be given just by the initial condition provided with the differential equation. So we're starting with an exact value and then making our approximations from there. So since y of 0 equals 2, I'm just told that in the problem, that value of 2 is going to be my starting point for my approximations. Now from this point, we're just simply plugging into the formula to find each successive iteration of Euler's method. So let's go ahead and calculate what u1 should be. Okay, so u1 should be u0 plus f of t0 u0 times delta t. And then we can start plugging in the respective parts here. So u0, I just said, was 2, plus f of t0 we found up here to be 0. Once again, u0 is 2, and delta t is 0.5. So then what I probably want to do is actually calculate f of 0 comma 2. So we'll just do that out to the side here. So remember, The 0 represents my t value, and the 2 represents my y value. So I can just plug this into my function, 2t plus y. And it looks like I get 2. So if I plug that in, I get 2 plus 2 times 0.5. So that's 2 plus 1, or 3. So I have found that u1 equals 3. And that's my first approximation. And then I simply continue building off this approximation to find u2. So u2 should be u1 plus f of t1 u1 times delta t. u1 we just found was 3, so this becomes 3 plus f of t1. We said that was 0.5. u1, 3, times delta t, which once again is 0.5. So out to the side then, we'll calculate f of 0.5 comma 3, which once again I'm just plugging into 2t plus y. So that should be 2 times 0.5 plus 3. So 1 plus 3, or 4. So plugging that in, we get 3 plus 4 times 1/2. So 3 plus 2, or 5. So then my second approximation is 5. And so remember, this is an approximation to y of 1, we had said before. Okay, and then we just have one more step. We were asked to find the first three approximations. So we'll finish out by calculating u3 using the same process. So u3 is u2. Plus f of t2 u2 times delta t. u2 we just found to be 5, so 5 plus f of t2 is 1. u2 is 5 times delta t, which is 0.5. Okay, so let's calculate what f of 1 comma 5 is. So that should be 2 times 1 plus 5, or 7. So this becomes 5 plus 7 times 1/2. So 5 plus 3.5, or 8.5. So then u3 is 8.5. And that is an approximation to the exact solution at a time of 1.5. So this is how you use Euler's method, and of course you could continue and get as many approximations as you wanted using the same iterative process.